Right. So let us start today's class. Before that, so in the last classes, I told you about band pass noise. Yes or not? So what I told you actually, so the noise is NFT. We call noise as NFT, isn't it? So if you pass this noise through any bandpass filter, what do you get? You get NIFT. So this is called bandpass noise. Okay. Why? Because so what is the first block of any receiver? Band pass filter. So you go and check in super heterodyne receiver. What is the first block? A band pass filter, RF section. So this was RF section. So for every receiver, the first thing is we have a band pass filter. Okay. And so when you pass this noise through this filter, it is called band pass noise. Now you know already the PSD of a noise, this noise is eta by 2 for all frequencies. This is a noise PSD. Okay, you know already. This is a PSD of what noise? AWGN noise. Correct? Now here, so I have written NIFT. Something like this. What I've written? NCFT cos omega CT plus what is another term? NSFT sin omega CT. So this is the way we write NIFT. Now NIFT equal to NCFT cos omega CT plus NSFT sin omega CT. Now here this term, the first term is called in-phase component. And this term is called, it is called quadrature phase. Okay, remember this. So any bandpass signal can be written like this. Not only this noise, you take any signal, it can be written like this. Okay, what is that? So NIFT equal to NCFT cos omega CT plus NSFT sin omega CT. Okay, now so this part is called in phase component. This part is called quadrature phase component. But remember, NIFT is bandpass. What about this NCFT, NSFT? This NSFT and NCFT, what kind of signals are they? Anybody can tell me? If NIFT is band pass, what about this NCFT, NSFT? Who will tell me the answer? Yeah, obviously they are low pass signals. Remember this, in this expression, NIFT is a band pass, but these two are low pass. Not, I'm just, be careful, NCFT, NSFT are low pass signals. Okay, so the entire term, the upper term is called in phase, the lower term is called quadrature phase. See, so let me write one more thing here. Actually, any band pass signal can be written in this form. For example, DSBSC. What is a modulated signal of DSBSC form? What do you write? M of T into cos omega CT. Isn't it? This is the DSBSC signal. I am not writing AC here. AC, assume that one. S of T equal to M of T into C of T. S of T is a band pass signal. What about M of T? It's a low pass signal or baseband signal. So when you multiply low pass with cos omega CT or sin omega CT, it becomes band pass or pass band. Okay. Now in DSBSC, what is the in-phase component? What in-phase component? This in-phase component. What are quarter in-phase component? What is a quarter phase component of DSBSC? Zero. It is not there. Okay, so this is a in-phase and quarter phase components. Any band pass signal can be written in this form. Please remember. Okay, so some people write minus. Yeah, some people write minus here. So no problem. You can write plus or minus actually. So now we prefer only plus. Okay. Now, so here, if you take DSBSC or AM, so what is the bandwidth of these signals? Why is the message bandwidth? Okay, so that's why the band pass filter at the front of the receiver side will be a band pass filter with a bandwidth how much? 2W. This is zero. So this would be the band pass filter at the starting of the receiver for DSBSC and AM. You take any receiver of DSBSC or AM, obviously they'll have a band pass filter bandwidth 2W because the bandwidth of this signal is itself is 2W. Now, so when you pass noise through this, when you pass noise N of T through this, it becomes N I of T. Is it okay? Are you getting or not? Now, so as simple as that. Now here is a filter with impulse response with a transfer function H of F. Input is N of T. Output is N I of T. Now you know already. So what is the PSD of output? Equal to mod H of F whole square into PSD of input. Do you know this or not? Now what is the PSD of input? What is the PSD to this filter? N of T. Whose PSD is what? Like this. Now what about output PSD would be? What happens? So this PSD is something like this, eta by 2. Now what about output PSD would be? Can you tell me what would be the output PSD now? What happens? So this is the bandwidth 2W. It is also 2W. What this value would be? Eta by 2. This is the output PSD. Or PSD of which signal? Ni of T. After passing through band pass filter, this is a PSD. Now how to get power? How to get power? Power is nothing but area under PSD. Isn't it? Now this is a PSD. What is area under this? What area? So eta by 2 into 2W plus eta by 2 into 2W. How much? Area is eta by 2 into 2W into 2. Okay, what do you get now? 2 eta W. So that's why we have written. What have you written? I told you an important statement. What is that? So let me write Ni of T here. Ni of T equal to NC of T cos omega CT plus NS of T sin omega CT. Okay. Now here I told you one important statement. What is that? Ni square bar, which means power of NIT, which is same as power of NIT. power in NC of T, which is same as power in NS of T. So power of the signal is same as power of the signal is same as power of the signal. The in phase component and the quarter phase component and this component will have same power. That equal to how much here? 2 eta w. Please remember, it is 2 eta w if and only if this band pass filter is of bandwidth how much? 2 w. Why? Because if the bandwidth changes, this power change. Is it okay? So this is about it is true for what signals? DSBSC and AM. See, remember, this is true for any kind of signal. This upper statement is true for any kind of signals. But it is equal to 2 eta w if and only if it is DSBSC or AM. Why? Because they have a bandwidth of 2 w. Okay. Suppose if it is SSB or VSB. VSB is not approximately correct, but it is for SSB. If it is for SSB, what happens? What a bandwidth of SSB? W. Obviously, at the front of the receiver, we use the bandwidth, we use the band pass filter of bandwidth only. How much? W. Why? Because our signal bandwidth is W. Okay, here we don't use a bandwidth of 2 W. That is meaningless. So obviously, what happens now? So this is eta by 2, it is also eta by 2. What about the power of this PSD will be now? What the power now? Area under PSD. What is area? Rectangle. This is a rectangle, no? What is area? So eta by 2 into W, 2 times. This area plus this area. Now it becomes only eta W. So obviously, here what happens? In case of SSB or VSB, I am taking VSB also. For VSB, it is approximately correct, not exactly. Why? Because for VSB, bandwidth is how much? Slightly more than W. FE plus W for VSB. You know all these things, right? So more or less, we assume that it is true for VSB also. Now in this case, what happens? N square bar equal to N square bar equal to N square bar. It is true always, but here it will be equal to only eta W. Is it okay? Right? Now, so similarly, you have to find out for any other signal. Okay? Now, so that's why, what you have taken? Yeah, so we have taken 2 eta W because it was for AM. DSBSC. So we have found out the SNR of DSBSC. What do you got? We are finding SNR. That is nothing but signal power by noise power. So this is a quantity that defines quality, noise power. SNR will define the quality of the output. If SNR is more, quality is good. Obviously, if SNR is more means for a given signal power, noise is less. If it is fixed, the noise is less. If the noise is less, obviously you get better quality. Okay. Now we always try to improve our SNR. Here I am referring to output SNR generally. Okay. Now, so in the last class, we have found out SNR of DSBSC, right? What do you got? SNR of DSBSC, that is nothing but gamma. That is same as input signal power by eta W. So what is this gamma is called? It is called baseband SNR. It is called baseband SNR. It is a benchmark. Okay, we compare any other system's SNR with this gamma. Okay, now, so here, so let us proceed for SSB. Now this is SSB basic diagram. Now I'm multiplying m of t with 2 cos 2 pi f ct. Why I'm using 2 here? Because in the last case of DSBSC, we have taken carrier as root 2 cos omega ct. Why? The reason is, so if you take like this, we got input signal power is same as output signal power is same as power of m of t. So I don't want to change these signal powers for comparison purpose. For comparison purpose, I want to maintain same input signal power. Input signal power same at SI, S naught. That should be equal to m square bar. Here, if I say m square bar means what? I told you in the last class also, m square bar means expectation of m of t whole square. This is nothing but mean square value. It gives you power. So to get SI equal to S naught equal m square bar, I have used root 2. Now in this case of SSB, I am using 2. Okay. So now this is the SSB modulator. This is the modulator or transmitter. This is the channel. Obviously, in the channel, noise will be added. So this is a receiver. But before receiver, I have a bandpass filter with bandwidth only W. Why? Because W is the bandwidth of this SSB signal itself. This is the synchronous demodulator. Okay. So for SSB, this is the representation. If it is plus, we call lower side band. If it is minus, we call upper side band. Here also you can observe. Okay. So here, okay, let me write SSB equation. For SSB, I'm writing S of t equal to m of t cos omega ct plus mh of t or m at of t sin omega ct. You can observe very clearly here. So here, this is a bandpass signal. M of t is a low pass signal. M hat of t is also low pass signal. This is a representation. Isn't it? Just now I told you. Any bandpass signal is written in this form. Now this is the in-phase component. What about this? This is the quadrature phase. Okay, so but this is SSB with what sideband? With what sideband? Lower sideband. So the question may, they may ask question like this: what is the quadrature phase component of SSB if it is using upper sideband? What is your answer? If it is upper sideband, what it becomes? It becomes minus. So then what is the quadrature component? Minus m at of t. Minus m at of t. If it is lower sideband, what is the quadrature component? M at of t. What in-phase component? It is always m of t. Okay. Now, so here, yeah, so I am taking one SSB signal. Here I am taking plus sign because I am transmitting lower sideband. So what happens now? So to this signal, noise will be added. And NI of t is a noise after bandpass filter. Now, yeah, obviously in this case of SSB, NI square bar equal to MG square bar equal to NI square bar equal to eta omega. Just now I told you. So here, now, yeah, so here, what happened now? Here, so the receiver, what are you getting? What is yi of t? That is s of t plus ni of t. It is the input side of receiver. Okay. So s of t is a SSB signal. What is s of t? You know already. M of t cos omega ct plus m hat of t sin omega ct. Okay. Now here, so without using input side of the receiver, we have to calculate two powers here also, right? Input signal power, input noise power. At the output side, we have to calculate output signal power, output noise power. So this is a receiver. Okay. Now what is the input signal power? What is that? What is the input signal power? So to calculate that, let us go to this diagram. Here, so what is this part? If you multiply m of t with 2 cos omega ct, you get double sideband suppressed carrier. If you use a filter, you get SSB. You know already how to get SSB. First, get DSBSC, remove one of the sidebands. Okay. So to calculate the power, I'll take DSBSC first. So what is the signal I'm getting? 2 m of t cos omega ct. This is DSBSC, please remember. From this, you have to remove one of the sidebands in this example. Okay. So what is the power of the signal? Can you tell me, anybody? What is the power of the signal? What the power of the signal? I told you. You assume that 2 m of t has an amplitude to this cos omega ct. I told you in the first unit itself. Because m of t varies very slowly compared to the omega ct. So 2 m of t is the amplitude of this cos omega ct. Then what is the power? 4 m square bar by 2. Would you agree with me? That is 2m square bar or pm. So if I assume power of cos omega ct is pm, it is 2pm. I told you these things already. But so this is the power of DSBSC. What the power of SSB would be? Half of that. Which means only m square bar. Do you agree with me? So in this case, input signal power is simply m square bar. That's why we are multiplying carrier with 2 to get signal power as m square bar. What do you got? M square bar. If it is not 2, you would have got something else. If it is root 2, you would have got something else. Okay. Right. So that is input signal power is m square bar. Now here, what is yi of t? S of t plus ni of t. But what is s of t like this? What is ni of t? What is ni of t? So ni of t equal to nc of t cos omega ct plus what? Ns of t sin omega ct. So this plus this. So what do you can write? What is common? Cos omega ct common, sin omega ct common. Then what do you can write? If take those things as common, what do you write? M of t plus nc of t into cos omega ct, next one, plus m dash of t plus ns of t into what? Sin omega ct. So this is the input to the demodulator. Okay. So yes. So this is multiply with 2 cos omega ct. Why? Because see in this figure, so yi of t is multiplied with 2 cos omega ct and later passed through low pass filter with bandwidth w. So then what happens? Yi of t should be multiplied with what? 2 cos omega ct. And passing the low pass filter, you get like this. This is output of the receiver. What do you get? After passing through this receiver, what you get here is, what do you get? After receiver, you get output as m of t plus nc of t. Now here, you got your signal back as well as with some noise. This is signal component, this is a noise component. This is our output side. Now what is the signal power, output signal power? Obviously the signal component is m of t, obviously it will be m square bar. What is the noise power? Nc square bar. That is how much in this case? Eta w. So obviously s naught by n naught, that equal to m square bar by eta w. That equal to what? Gamma. Okay. Now, so here in the lastly, I made one statement. This shows that baseband, DSBSC, and SSB waveforms identical in terms of performs identical in terms of resource utilization, because they have a same SNR, that is equal to gamma. That is a baseband SNR, also called as benchmark. Okay. So the SNR of DSBSC and SSB is same as that of baseband SNR. That equal to gamma. Gamma equal to m square bar by eta omega. Please remember this. It is very, very, very important. Gamma equal to m square bar by eta omega. Okay. Now that is about SSB. Obviously in BSB also more or less it is same, but it is approximately equal to gamma, not exactly. So S naught by naught equal to approximately equal to m square bar by eta omega, approximately equal to SA by eta omega, that is approximately equal to gamma. Here also you can say that it is approximately equal to gamma. Why? Because in BSB we use little bit more power and more bandwidth compared to the SSB. Why? Because we are transmitting some portion of the other sideband also. Because of that, we have to spend more bandwidth and more power, little bit more. Okay. Now, so let us move on to noise performance in AM. Okay. Noise performance in AM. So, what will you do in case of AM? What will you do in case of AM? What will you do in case of AM? Obviously, here the bandwidth is 2W. Here I should write NS square bar should be same as NC square bar is equal to NS square bar, that equal to 2 eta W. Okay, remember this. So this is a AM generator. Input is M of T, and after that we are passing through a channel. And noise added in the channel. Obviously, we use a band pass filter with a bandwidth twice the message frequency, that is 2W. And this is an envelope detector, the receiver. What is the demodulator for AM? The best one is ED. ED means envelope detector. And after that, we use a low pass filter. Okay. So this is a receiver. Okay. This is AM signal. Okay. Obviously, mu should be less than or equal to 1. Why? Because if at all you want to demodulate AM by using ED, it should be a undermodulated. It should be mu less than or equal to 1. This AM signal, I am assuming AC equal to 1. So input to the receiver. Obviously, S of T plus N I of T. So what do you input to the receiver? This is a receiver. So what happens here? This is a channel, and this is S of T, this is N I of T after band pass filtering. So this is input to the channel. Okay. So input to the channel is sum of signal component plus noise component N I of T. Okay. But what is S of t? I am assuming S of t as 1 plus mu cos omega m t into cos omega c t. Okay, this is input. Okay, so here we have to find out input power. Okay, input power, input signal power. Input side, this is signal component. Obviously, what the power of S of t? The transmitter power of S of t, you know already. What is that? Pc into 1 plus mu square by 2. But what is Pc? Actually, it is S square by 2. But here, what is Sc? 1. This is 1 by 2. Now, here the signal power, input signal power of is 1 by 2 into 1 plus mu square by 2. Yeah, but what is, how can you write this? Yi of t? Okay, so yi of t equal to sum of two signals, two components, signal component as well as noise component. Yi of t equal to, what do you write? 1 plus mu cos omega mt into cos omega ct, this is signal component. Plus noise. What is noise? Nc of t cos omega ct plus ns of t sine omega ct. So what are the common things? You take cos common here also here. Then what happens? Then what happens? So output, I mean, yi of t can be written as 1 plus nc of t plus mu cos omega mt into cos omega ct. Plus ns of t into sin omega ct. Do you agree or not? No. But here one thing is there. What is that is? Suppose you have a cos theta plus b sin theta. Then it can be written as, this is a rectangular form. Some kind of rectangular form. So what do you write this as? You can write this as a square plus b square cos theta minus alpha. Do you know this already? What is alpha equal to? Tan inverse b by a. Okay, this is one of the trigonometric identity. You might be knowing this already. It is okay. Now it is also in the same form. What is theta here? Theta is omega ct. This is theta. What is a? A is 1 plus n of t plus mu cos omega mt. This is a cos theta plus b. What is b? Ns of t. This is b sin theta. Obviously, that can be written as in the envelope form. What you can write? Root of a square plus b square. Means what? What is a square? 1 plus nc of t plus mu cos omega mt whole square plus b square. What is b square? Ns of t whole square. Cos theta minus alpha. Okay, here. I am writing this as ea of t cos omega ct plus theta of t. Ei of t is nothing but envelope of the signal. What is that? Okay, let me write here. So, now yi of t can be written as y of t can be written as root of a square plus b square cos theta minus alpha. Here what is theta equal to? Omega c into t. What is a square b square equal to? Root of a square plus b square equal to how much? Root of 1 plus nc of t plus u cos omega mt whole square plus under root, everything is under root, ns of t whole square. Okay, so what I want to say is I will write y I of t equal to some e I of t into cos omega ct minus some alpha. Here I am not calculating alpha. I am not calculating this. What is EI of t? Same as under root of a square plus b square. That is same as square root of 1 plus nc of t plus mu cos omega mt whole square plus ns of t whole square. So let me write EI of t here. So let me write EI of t here. So EI of t equal to, please understand this, 1 plus nc of t plus mu cos omega mt whole square plus ns of t whole square. Everything is under root. This is the EI of t. What is EI of t? Is the amplitude of yi of t. Please remember this. Amplitude of the signal yi of t. So yi of t equal to some amplitude cos omega ct minus alpha. So alpha is not required. So for yi of t, amplitude is ei of t. Or envelope. What is the envelope of yi of t? Mod ei of t. Here why I am going for envelope? Why? Because here the demodulator is ED. ED will detect envelope itself, right? Yeah. So the output would be mod of EA. Mod of EA of T. Mod of this. Okay. But. So. Now what I do here is I will take some assumptions. What assumptions I will take? Some assumptions. Because. So that cannot be calculated directly. Okay, what you got is output as something like this. This is envelope of the signal. Square root of this square plus this square. You have noise terms also. So here, remember, noise is adding to the signal. It is adding to the signal component. Now, next what happens? Assumption. I am assuming that small noise. Noise is small. What noise? Here noise is n of t or ni of t. It is small compared to what? Compared to what? Noise is small compared to the signal. What signal here? 1 plus mu. So that signal only. Yeah. So signal is more than noise. Or here this is signal component. In these two components we assume that this is a signal. This is a noise. Okay. So what I can say is, so signal is more than noise. Okay. What is more? Signal component. 1 plus nc of t plus mu cos omega mt. Okay, it is much more than NS of T. Let us assume that. So small noise means noise is very small compared to the signal component. So you compare this component with a noise. This is a noise. So simply I want to say we are comparing these two terms. 1 plus NC of T plus mu cos omega MT with NS of T. So this component is much larger than this component. Okay. So please remember, here I have written for almost all T. Generally we write for all T, but it is not true for each and every T. But most it is true. Okay. It is true for almost all times. Right. Obviously what happens? This term is much more than this term. So just by mathematics, you can neglect this term. You can neglect this term because the first term is much superior to the second term. So now approximately EI of T is what now? So simply I want to say in this expression of EI of T, this term is neglected. If it is small noise case, so obviously what do you get? Only this term. Okay, so what happens now? The output of the ED, that is envelope. Now what envelope now? Envelope of the signal, that is output, is approximately equal to 1 plus NC of T plus mu cos omega MT. This is the output of the what? The output of the demodulator. Okay. Now here we can write like this: 1 plus mu cos omega MT plus NC of T. So this is a signal part, this is a noise part. What is signal power? Output signal power, remember this. Output signal power, how much? What is the power of 1 plus mu cos omega MT? So what is the power of 1? It is a DC component. Okay. Now what is the power of mu cos omega MT? Mu square by 2. This is output. You can assume. This is output. What is the noise power? Output noise power. That is power of NC of T. That is NC square bar. That equal to here how much? 2 eta W. I told you, because it is AM. So what is S naught by N naught? You always take signal power to noise power ratio. That is M square bar by 2 eta W. Okay. But here what is SI? What is SI? I told you, input signal power is same as PT, same as how much? SI is how much? 1 by 2 into 1 plus mu square by 2. So 1 by 2 into 1 plus mu square by 2. But SI equal to 1 by 2 into 1 plus mu square by 2. So what is gamma generally? SI by eta W. Obviously, what is here now? Gamma equal to, what do you write gamma as? 1 by 2 eta W into 1 plus mu square by 2. Now here S naught by N naught equal to, what is that? M square bar by 2 eta omega. M square bar by 2 eta omega. So, but we want to write this in terms of gamma. What do you write? What is s naught by naught? Okay, so here I forgot to tell you, what is m square bar? Yeah, so here output power is how much you got? Mu square by 2, sorry. It is mu square by 2, no? M square bar is but mu square by 2. What is s naught? Mu square by 2. SI is this much. So this is mu square by 4 eta double. Okay. So let me write everything clearly here. S naught by N naught equal to how much? Mu square by 4 eta W. But what is eta? What is gamma? Gamma equal to SI by eta omega, that is 1 by 2 eta omega, 1 by 2 eta omega into 1 plus mu square by 2. So here I want to write S naught by N naught equal to some k into gamma, some k into this one. How to write this now? Okay, S naught by N naught equal to mu square by 4 eta w, that equal to some k into, what is gamma? 1 by 2 eta omega into 1 plus mu square by 2. I want to write S naught by naught in terms of this gamma. Always you should write in terms of gamma. I told you already. DSBSC, what is S naught by naught? Gamma, which means k equal to 1. SSB, it is gamma, which means k equal to 1. BSB also equal to gamma, which means k is approximately equal to 1. Let us see here, what is k? So 2 eta omega means mu square by 2 here. Next, what happens? 1 by 2 mu square by 2 equal to k into 1 plus mu square by 2. What is k now? Mu square 2 by 1 plus square by 2. So that equal to mu square by 2 plus mu square. Which means S naught by N naught equal to mu square by 2 plus mu square into some gamma. Now it is not equal to gamma. It is not equal to the baseband SNR. It is not equal to baseband SNR, but it is equal to some constant into gamma. What is that constant? Mu square by 2 plus mu square. Okay. So remember, obviously it is for what signal? Tone modulation. Tone means if take only if take MFT equal to some AM cos omega MT. So for tone modulation, it is equal to mu square by what is that? S naught by naught equal to mu square by 2 plus mu square into some gamma. The last one approximately equal to mu square by 2 plus mu square into some gamma. Okay. In general, it is m square bar by a square plus m square bar into gamma. Please remember, it is for tone modulation. In general, it is what? S naught by N naught equal to m square bar by a square plus m square bar into gamma. What is a square? What is a? Amplitude of the carrier. Okay, now it is for any general signal. This is the output SNR of any general IM signal. Please remember, and what conditions? What condition? Small noise. whenever noise is small compared to the signal component. If noise is large, second case, which means noise component is more than signal component. Here, see, this is the output of the receiver. Here I am taking two conditions. What are they? Small noise, which means this first component is more than second component. Then what I have done? I have neglected second component. So output is simply first component. You have done some calculations. Okay. If reverse happens, which means so noise is more compared to the signal, which means NSoft is more than this component. Second term is more than first term. What will happen? So noise will be multiplicative in nature. The noise, what happens? It will multiply. Just now I told you somewhere here. What is happening here? So if take the output, properly, yeah, this output here noise is added, no? So if you take everything into consideration, so we do some calculations, you can see that noise will be multiplying with the signal. So if noise multiplies the signal, that is a very, very dangerous thing. Okay. So what will happen? So here noise will be multiplicative. In this situation, the useful signal is badly mutilated. Okay. Which means output is noisy. Total noise with no component is proportional to M of T. So you get only noise. Noise will be buried in the signal will be buried in the noise. Okay. So if you take large noise case, what happens? If you take large noise, we cannot calculate the signal properly. What will happen? You get output is totally noisy. Total noise. You get total noisy output. So in this case, what happens? Signal is deeply buried in the noise. Okay, so this situation we should avoid. If noise is large, AM will not work perfectly. But anyway, this is not that significant because it doesn't occur often. Okay, mostly noise will be small. Please remember, I am saying noise is small compared to the signal component. I am not saying simply noise is small. What I am saying is, noise is small means this component, otherwise let me write here, this component, signal component, 1 plus mu cos omega mt is more than noise component. This is the definition, small noise. This is what I want to mean. Much, much more than this is small noise. Okay. If noise is large, so you get output as noisy output. Okay. So this is about performance of noise in AM and SS. Any doubts you can ask me. Okay. So as I told you, in the coming Saturday, from 10 to 11, we have an exam. Okay. So if any doubts, you can ask me, please.
Sir.
What tell me?
Sir, once explain about quadrature and in-phase components, sir.
Okay, okay. I think I made some mistake, right? Okay, let me tell you one thing. Okay. Here, any bandpass signal, you take X of T. Any bandpass signal can be written as in phase component. Let me use another terms otherwise. Xi of t in phase into cos omega ct plus quadrature phase. I am using different notations, please don't get confused. Otherwise, let me write c only. Okay. Let me write c only. I have to confuse you. Okay. Xi of t cos omega ct plus x s of t sin omega c t. Okay, now this is the in phase component. And this is the quadrature phase. Okay, but this is a band pass signal. But these two are obviously low pass or baseband. So any signal can be written in this form. Okay, so in the same way we are writing noise. NIFT is a band pass signal because after passing through band pass filter it becomes band pass noise. We are writing as in phase component plus quadrature phase component. Okay, so in some textbooks they will write this is in terms of C they will write I, in terms of S they will write Q. NIFT cos omega CT plus NSFT cos omega. This is not I actually, should not be I now. Now what I want to say is, so suppose you take AM signal equation. What is that S of T? Okay, what do you write? AC into 1 plus KA M of T into cos omega CT. Okay, now this is a band pass signal. Obviously it is a band pass signal. After modulating everything, every signal becomes pass band or band pass, both are same. Now here you compare with the notation of in phase quadrature phase. What I told you, any band pass signal can be written as in phase component into cos omega ct plus some quadrature component. Okay, so it is not correct. Let us write x only. I want to avoid confusion. Okay, x of t is a band pass signal, let us take. Now that equal to in phase component x of t cos omega ct plus quadrature phase x s of t sin omega ct. Every band pass signal can be written in this form. Okay, now if it is a band pass signal, what is the in phase component? What in phase component? What is that? AC into what? 1 plus KM of T. Here XC of T. But here what? What is the in phase component of the signal? S of T.
Amplitude of cos.
AC into 1 plus cos KM of whatever is there here, should write. AC into 1 plus KM of T. What is the quadrature phase component? Zero. Okay, now here what I want to say is, in AM the in phase component is xc of t. In phase component is AC into 1 plus KAM of t. The quadrature phase component is zero. But what is this component? It is not a band pass signal. It is a low pass signal. Low pass filter or low pass signal. Do you agree or not? Because it is only M of T is there. M of T is a low pass signal. 1 plus KA, they are all simply DC addition. Okay, in the same way, in DSBSC, what will the DSBSC as? S of T equal to AC M of T into cos omega CT. What is in phase component? AC M of T. What is the quadrature component? Zero. Okay. In SSB, you take, like it is upper side band, if you take upper side band, what happens? What is S of t? M of t into cos omega c t plus, what is that next? Plus m hat of t sin omega c t. Upper side band, no, it is, should be negative, right? Sorry. Okay, it should be negative. Minus m hat of t sin omega c t. Now we are both are present, isn't it? So what in phase component? M of t. What is your component? Minus m hat of t. So in phase is xc of t equal to m of t. The quadrature phase component is xs of t equal to minus m hat of t. So both are low pass signals again. Okay. Right. I hope I answered your question. Any other doubts? So if you don't have any doubts, we'll stop here. Right? Okay. Thank you.